गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम बैक टू जीके टुडे एंड टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एमसीक्यूज फॉर 24th ऑफ सेप्टेम्बर 2021. स्टार्टिंग विथ वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, ऑन विच डेट इंटरनेशनल इक्वल पे डे वॉज सेलिब्रेटेड. सो ऑन 18th ऑफ सेप्टेम्बर 2021 द इंटरनेशनल इक्वल पे डे वॉज सेलिब्रेटेड. एज वी नो दैट इन ऑल रीजन्स वुमेन्स पे इज लोअर दैन मेन्स and the global gender pay gap is estimated to be 23%. And hence, the Equal Pay International Coalition is led by International Labour Organization along with UN Women and partners. And the goal of this alliance is to achieve equal pay for men and women everywhere. Fine. Now apart from it, on same day, that is on 18th of September, World Bamboo Day is observed globally, and the purpose of this day is to raise the world's awareness of the protection and promotion of the bamboo industry and bamboo plantations. So this special day was celebrated by World Bamboo Organization, which aims to protect natural resources and the entire environment. And the organization also intends to ensure the sustainable use of the bamboo and promote traditional uses for the economic development of local communities. So this year theme was hashtag plant bamboo. It is time to plant bamboo. Now apart from it, on same day, that is on 18th of September, one more day is observed named as World Water Monitoring Day. Why? To increase public participation and awareness regarding water resources protection and monitoring around the world. And what was the theme for this day? Valuing water. Okay, now you have to tell me, when do we celebrate World Water Day and what was the theme for this year? Please write in the comment section. Now every year on third Saturday of September month, International Red Panda Day is celebrated to increase public awareness and support to the protection of red pandas. Also on same day, that is on third Saturday of September, every year the International Coastal Cleanup Day is held. Why? To create awareness regarding protection of the oceans from the challenges that it faces every year. And this year theme was keep trash in the bin and not in the ocean. Fine. Now question number 2. Recently, who has become India's 70th Grandmaster in chess? So this is Raja Ritwik from the state of Telangana, and he has crossed ELO 25,000 mark at Weser Kebzo GM Chess Championship, which was held recently in Budapest, Hungary. Sorry, this is 2500 actually. So he has crossed this ELO 2500 mark and became the 70th Grandmaster of India after defeating the FIDE Master Fenek Vakiav, and he is from Zeko, Slovakia. Now apart from it, recently at 60th National Open Athletics Championships, which was held at Nehru Stadium in Warangal, B. Aishwarya of the Railway won the women's long jump gold medal with a personal best of 6.52 meters. Then Railway's Parul Chaudhary won the gold medal in women's 3000 meter steeplechase with a personal best time of 9:51. And in the women's 1500 meters, Harmilan Kaur won gold, breaking the record of Sunita Rani, which she made in the year 2002. Okay. Then apart from it, the official motto of the Olympic and Paralympic Winter Games Beijing 2022 has recently been revealed, and what is that? Together for a shared future. And already we have talked about US Open in the previous lecture. Today let's revise few things regarding Paralympics. First of all, do remember that India finishes 24th with record 19 medals, which include 5 gold, 8 silver and 6 bronze. And this is the best medal tally for India in a single edition of Paralympic Games ever. Okay. Then flag bearer at opening ceremony of Tokyo Paralympics was Tej Chand, who is a javelin thrower. While for the closing ceremony, it was Avani Lekhara, and she is a shooter. And Team China topped the final medal tally at Tokyo Paralympics. Also, the Indian theme song of Paralympic was Kar De Kamal Tu, which was composed and sung by Sanjeev Singh, who is a Divyang cricket player from Lucknow. Okay. Now, question number 3. Who has been sworn in as the 16th Chief Minister of Punjab? So, this is Charanjit Singh Channi. And he became the first individual from the Dalit community in Punjab to hold this post. And he was sworn in by the Governor of Punjab, Banwarilal Purohit. Now, apart from it, our new Governor of Uttarakhand is Gurmeet Singh. Then our new Governor of Tamil Nadu is R.N. Ravi. And obviously, the new Governor of Punjab is Banwarilal Purohit. Now, earlier we have seen that recently government has constructed an 8-member panel for framing a new law for drugs, cosmetics and medical services. And this panel is being headed by DCGI Dr. V.G. Somani. Also, central government has selected S.L. Tripathi as chairman cum MD of United India Insurance Company Limited. Then Nirlep Singh Rai has been appointed as chairman and MD of NFL, that is National Fertilizers Limited. And Iqbal Singh Lalpura has been chosen as chairman of National Commission for Minorities. Then our new Secretary General of Rajya Sabha is Dr. Ramacharyalu. And J.B. Mohapatra has been appointed as chairman of CBDT, means Central Board of Direct Taxes. Okay. Question number 4. With which country India is participating in the military training exercise Suri Kiran? So India and Nepal has begun a 15-day military exercise in Pithorgarh, which is located in the state of Uttarakhand, with a focus on counter-terror drills and disaster relief operations. So this has been started on 20th of September. And this is the 15th edition of India-Nepal military training exercise named as Suri Kiran, and being held to boost interoperability between the two militaries. Now, a few days back, Exercise Peaceful Mission 2021 was being held by Russia. Also, Ukraine began joint military exercise with US and other NATO forces on 20th of September 2021. So, this military exercise is being conducted at that time, during which neighboring countries like Russia and Belarus were conducting large-scale exercises which aroused the vigilance of the West. So, this exercise is named as Rapid Trident 2021, and this will continue until 1st of October. Now, a few days back, Indian Navy and Vietnam Navy have carried out a joint exercise in South China Sea, in which INS Ranvijay and INS Kora participated. Also, India and Australia have recently signed joint guidance for naval cooperation. Then apart from all these things, every year United Nations Day for South-South Cooperation is celebrated globally on 12th of September. And this is an initiative for economic, social and political development of the countries in the southern region. Fine. Also, talking about Australia, recently it has said that it will support India's Gaganyaan mission by tracking it through Cocos Keeling Islands. Fine. Question number 5. Which state has launched Music Bus to train students in audio production, film production and graphic designing? So the Delhi government has launched a Music Bus which will train students in various fields, and this is the first mobile music classroom and recording studio in India. and it was launched at the School of Specialized Excellence in Performing and Visual Arts with the aim to help the children of Delhi State School to pursue their passion for music. Okay. Now, a few days back, the Deputy Chief Minister of Delhi, Manish Sisodia, has launched the Business Blasters program, and this program aims at developing young entrepreneurs at the school level by providing them seed money to start a business. Also recently, Mr. Bhupendra Yadav, who is our Environment Minister, has virtually inaugurated the first functional smog tower in India at Anand Vihar, New Delhi. And this tower would be used as air purifiers to decrease the air pollution, usually by forcing the air through filters. And already we have seen that our Union Minister Sarbanand Sonowal recently announced that world's first biobank in Ayurveda is going to be set up in All India Institute of Ayurveda, New Delhi. Also, AIIMS Delhi has become the first hospital in the country to house a fire station in its campus. And few days back, Delhi has also launched faceless transport services by locking down 4 of its RTOs. RTOs means regional transport offices. Okay. Question number 6. With which organization TRIFED has partnered for the promotion and sale of the natural Vandhan products? So the Tribes India Vandhan expanded online marketing by cooperation with Big Basket. And hence TRIFED and Big Basket signed a memorandum of understanding to promote and sell Vandhan's natural products through the Big Basket platform. Okay. Now apart from it, also TRIFED has signed a memorandum of understanding with Purti Agrotech of Jharkhand. Why? To develop entrepreneurship of tribals in the pearl farming industry nationwide. So this MOU will basically promote the art of pearl cultivation among other tribal entrepreneurs in India and unlock the potential of this market. Fine. Now apart from all these things, a typical Menhir stone slab from the megalithic era has recently been discovered in the medieval historic town of Basrur on the west coast of India. Question number 7. With which organization Davinta has partnered to provide credit facilities to MSMEs? So recently Flipkart Wholesale has partnered with Davinta, which is a small medium enterprise lending platform, to provide credit facilities for affiliated retailers. So now both the organizations will provide MSME and Kiranas with a buy now pay later credit facility. And talking about Davinta, it is headquartered in Bangalore and was founded by former Flipkart CTO Ravi Garikipati and American entrepreneur Raj Vattikuti. Now apart from it, recently Flipkart and Indian Naval Placement Agency have signed a memorandum of understanding in which both the companies will review the opportunities to recruit naval veterans with the Flipkart group. Also, the Department of Food and Public Distribution, which comes under Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, has signed a model agreement with CSC E-Governance Services India Limited to increase the income and business opportunities of various fair price shops by providing CSC services to the interested fair price shop distributors. Fine. Question number 8. In FSSAI's third state food safety index, which measures the performance of states across 5 parameters of food safety, which state has topped among the larger states? So recently our health minister Mansukh Mandavi has released this index, which is used to measure the performance of states in food safety parameters. So this year Gujarat was ranked highest among the larger states, and it was further followed by Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Then among the smaller states, Goa appeared first, and it was further followed by Meghalaya and Manipur. In terms of union territory, Jammu Kashmir, Andaman Nicobar Islands and New Delhi topped the list. Also, 19 mobile food testing vans were flagged off by the minister to supplement the national food safety ecosystem, bringing the total number of these mobile inspection vehicles to 109. Now, apart from it, NMHC, that is National Maritime Heritage Complex, is to be developed as an international tourist destination, and it will be dedicated to the legacy of maritime heritage of India at Lothal in Gujarat. And also we have talked about a GI certified product from Gujarat. It is Bhalia variety of wheat, and it was in news because last month first shipment of this product was exported to the countries of Kenya and Sri Lanka. Now also last month we have seen that Gujarat government has decided to grant Center of Excellence status to 7 private universities in the state. Can you name at least 3? Please write in the comments if you know. And yes, don't forget that Sirarak Hong Chili and Taming Long Orange have recently got the GI tag and they belong to Manipur. Question number 9. What is India's rank in the 2021 edition of Global Innovation Index launched by World Intellectual Property Organization? So recently the 2021 edition of Global Innovation Index was published by World Intellectual Property Organization, and it shows the latest global innovation rankings of 132 economies based on 81 different indicators. So in this list, Switzerland, Sweden, US and UK continue to lead the innovation rankings and have entered the top 5 in the past 3 years. Also do remember that South Korea will be among the top 5 in this particular index for the very first time in 2021. So India ranks 46th in this list, while 4 other Asian countries are there in this list. And which are these? While 4 other Asian countries are in the top 15, and which are these? Singapore at 8th place, China at 12th, Japan at 13th, and Hong Kong at 14th. Fine. Now apart from it, what is the India's rank in Global Coronavirus Innovations Ranking? So in this, India is ranked at 32nd. Then apart from it, India's rank in Global Youth Development Index is 122 among 181 countries. And this index basically measures the condition of young people. And in this, Singapore was at the top position, while Niger was at the last. And as per ICMR's serology survey that was released in the month of July, MP has the highest COVID-19 sero prevalence, while Kerala has the lowest. And MP was further followed by Rajasthan and Bihar. Okay. Coming to last question, which ministry is celebrating Vanijya Saptah from 20 to 26 September? So Ministry of Commerce is organizing special programs and events named Vanijya Saptah as part of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. And hence National Single Window System and Industrial Park Rating System platforms will be launched by Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade during this event period. Okay. Now apart from it, Ministry of Railway has decided to train 50,000 youths under Rail Kaushal Vikas Yojana. And Ministry of Law and Justice has launched a pan-India special campaign named as Ek Pehel Drive for justice delivery at doorstep. Also, the Union Ministry for Road Transport has launched I Raste, which is a 2-year pilot project that aims to enhance road safety in the state of Nagpur. And now you have to tell me, what does I Raste stands for? Please write in the comment section. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide, you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions. And at the end of the lecture, do not forget to share your scores in the comment section. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today. And we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Satsana signing off.